السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. الحمد لله وذ الله بركة سبحانه وتعالى. Once again, we're blessed to be here together. And inshallah tonight to continue. Inshallah tonight the teaching of Shamail Muhammadiyah, the description of the blessed appearance of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And inshallah tonight we are page 63. What is this? I can't read the
cushions.
No. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم cushions and how he reclined, how he used to sit صلى الله عليه وسلم. This also covered by Sahaba رضي الله عنهم. Always we said whenever they are, whenever you read you see that how they used to monitor رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, and that shows the love, the pure love they have towards him صلى الله عليه وسلم. May Allah grant us rahman barakah fi dunya and akhirah. So we read the first hadith. The first one is the messenger of Allah's manner of walking, sitting and lying down. Qablah naam. Naam. Page 61. Okay, the first hadith. An Abi Hurairata radiallahu anhu qal, ما رأيت شيئا أحسن من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كأن الشمس تجري في وجهه، ولا رأيت أحدا أسرع في مشيته من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كأنما الأرض تطوى له، وإنا لنجهد أنفسنا وإنه لغير مكترث صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعم، اقرأ الحديث.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أبو هريرة said.
Is it on the mic?
Yeah. نعم. أبو هريرة said, never have I seen anything more beautiful than a messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. It was as if the rays of the sun permeated in his face.
نعم.
Moreover, I have never seen anyone walk as fast as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was as if the earth was folded up for him. He would tire, we would tire ourselves out, whilst he would carry on regardless.
Naam, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he is one of those whom, of course, you can see in all the books of hadith narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. And he was one of the greatest followers of Sahaba, Sayyidina Rasulullah. And he asked him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, something about him. He have asked Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once, said, Ya Rasulullah, do something for me so that I can remember your sayings and the knowledge of yours. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, say, okay, take out your aba'a, the cloak, Sayyidina Abu Hurairah's cloak. So he took it out and he put it in the ground, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam touched it like that. In other narration, he do like this. And it's like something truth on it. Huh? And he wear it. He says, since that time, I never miss memorizing any of his hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After that, so Sayyidina Abu Huraira, he won't miss any knowing about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his life, and he know how to mention about the hadith, the saying of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Sahaba trust him too much, and he was one of those whom Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah especially depend on his narrations of hadith in all the books of hadith, alhamdulillah. So Sayyidina Abu Hurairah said, I have not seen anything. When he say anything, in Arab language, anything is mean everything created by Allah. Because sometimes anything is mean small things also. But in the language of Quraysh, the language of Arabs, is mean anything, everything. So he said, I have seen anything more beautiful than the Messenger's face, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Or himself, so he said, like, looks like the sun is circulating in his face. Al-ulama said, you can see there's other narrations that they say Nur, Qamar. And Allah described in Quran, Sirajan Munira, Qamaran Munira, Siraj Munir, Siraj Wahaj. So from moon and from the sun, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But when someone say he is like moon, the Nur of his face, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mean the beauty, because you would like to see the moon, especially on the dark night. The moon is so nice when you look to it, especially if it's in the 15th, al-Badr they call. That's why when Rasulullah came to Medina, طَلَعَ al-Badru alayna. And he have reached to them, he have entered Medina by the way in the daytime, between Zuhr and Asr. So the better that the moon can be seen for them even daytime. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طَلَعَ al-Badru alayna, صحيح? In the daytime, not at night. The meaning, it's the beauty. How you describe someone, you say, you are the moon of my life. And not mean the moon of my life only at night time. We have to be also daytime. So they here mention about the beauty. Sayyidina Abu Hurairah here said, the sun. What that mean? He said, because the moon is beautiful, but it got its light from the sun. So Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, for me, he is a source of nur, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, alayhi sallam. That's how, because al-shu'ara, the poet, the people with kind and soft-hearted, they know how to describe the things. They're just not saying something. They will mention. And when they say something, that mean is the meaning of it. So here he said, like sun circulating in his blessed face, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, I have never seen anyone walk as fast as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not that mean he walked very fast, but he walked normally. That's his normal walking, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's like something similar to army walk. But he moved a little bit right and left. And when he put his leg, his feet, when you know, he's like very well organized. And he won't walk, like sometimes the lady is very shy, so they when they walk a bit soft and a bit, you know, that they style, how they shy. And but he walked like men, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Sahaba, we are very tired. And he walk looks like nothing. We're like breathing. But he, when he walked, looks like nothing. Looks like, he said, looks like the land, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subjected to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How they describe that? Because he used to walk with him, and he know. Of course, walking, those days, imagine, not nowadays. We walk, he drive a car and we feel too far. How about walking in the sun, in the sunny, like when people go to majlis, as nowadays, they choosy also. Not, they go to masjid also, they choosy. They want the masjid to be at the entrance of their house. Yet they won't pray also there. So the majalis also, majlis barakah, majlis zikr, majlis ta'lim, majlis mawlid, majlis shama'il, majlis. People, Allah, we love that, we love program. When the program come, where are they? Sitting at home playing with his phone. Well, I will say, maybe you can waste some time, our time. We cannot waste. But in case of wasting time, we shouldn't waste our time in Rabi'ul Awwal or in Ramadan. صح? These seasons where Allah offer His ibad special in Rabi'ul Awwal to remember Al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. especially for the lovers of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the time talk about his love, at the end of the day, they are stay at home. I don't know what they're doing. And during Ramadan also, very lazy. لا حول ولا قوة. But the signs of آخر الزمان. Quality of people of آخر الزمان. We don't want to be this type of quality. We want to be the good quality. Inshallah. And the Sahaba, they are not angels. Are they angels? They're men like us. They are not different. They are similar to us. Are there any difference between us and them? Physically, no. Heart, yes. Their love is different. Their attitude is different. Their listening is different. Their observation is different. Their teaching is different. That's why they are the best. So Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said 3 centuries, his century, later and the later. Sahaba, Tabi'in, Tabi'ut, Tabi'in. After that, and you can see it's declining. In what? Not in deen. Deen, many people, 1.5 billion. But what's the issue now? A quality of deen. That's the issue. May Allah give us courage. Our love have to be genuine, inshallah. So he was, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's how Sayyidina Abu Hurairah, radiallahu anhu, so he's the walking of Al-Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he walked like nothing. But we are tired. That shows why he always bit front. And sometimes he delay, because he know the people is, he will walk slowly, because he know the people, they're a bit tired. And he mentioned about him, when he was walking, going to Baqi' or I think an invitation, Ahad al-Ansar, where the people, Sahaba following him, and you know, he saw many of them. Many of you who feel happy when you walk front and people behind you. Many people like love this. Now there are lots of people like that. If you go to Majlis alone, maybe not attention, but you go to the crowd, oh, must be his, yani, Imam al-Bukhari here. You know what he's, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw once this situation, he delay a bit, he walks slowly, he say, you just go front, I want to do like something. Why? He don't like the takabbur, na'udhu billah. He has no takabbur, but he wants to teach the Sahaba and teach us. So when we read, we understand these qualities. Nowadays, if not many people, how many people going to come? 100. Only? What they going to say about me? Yahi is not the people who they're going to give you value. It's yourself. If you are good, people like. Even if they are anywhere. May Allah grant us barakah fi dunya al-akhirah. Okay, next hadith. We came across this hadith, but it's a very nice hadith, and inshallah we read it again. Before in different chapter. The hadith said, "An Qaylata binti Makhrama, she's a girl. أنها رأت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في المسجد وهو قاعد القرفصاء فقالت فلما رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم المتخشع في الجلسة أرعدت من الفرق."
نعم. Qaylah bint Makhrama relates that she saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a mosque sitting in a qurfasa position. She said, "When I saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sitting humbly, I suddenly trembled in fear."
Nah. Okay. Qayla came. This, if we just to recall the story. She came to see Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in the narration, she was carrying, in one of the narration, a plate of dates, kajur, kurma. So for her to go on, they say, "Come, we see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." So she was imagining how he looks like, how he used to sit. Because when you see stories, you read about kings. So she went to see him. So she came to see him. She was very young, and he was sitting القرفصاء. القرفصاء position Haji T. I wanted to see Haji Ghazan, how he's going to sit. Sit here, Haji. They can have to see you. That's what we call القرفصاء. He was sitting like that with few people like with him, Sayyidina Umar. That's the sitting of Sayyidina Rasulullah. Is the sitting of kings? The king will sit like that? The VVIP sit like this? No. He used to like to sit like that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On his, only on his legs, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what we call al-qurfusa. This is a way of sitting. So when she came, and they say, this is Rasulullah. When she came to Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she saw him sitting like that, like how, you know, Ghazan sitting, and she was come from the side to see him. So he turned to her, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he looked, his eyes looked to her eyes, she was shocked. She don't know what to do. So Sayyidina Umar, he said, Ar'atta al-miskina ya Rasulullah, ya Rasulullah, you frighten her like. But she was, you know, is not frightened, but she rahba, the might like, subhanAllah, the jalal, what you call it, of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he put his hand on her, like, you know, and he said, Ya miskina alayki sakina. Oh miskina, may Allah give you tranquility. To that very little girl. Ya miskina alayki sakina. You can use this sometimes your children maybe a bit frightened or something. Put your hand on their inani or on their chest. Is of a girl, ya miskina alayki sakina. If boy, ya miskin alayka sakina. Miskin for what? Boy. Girl, miskina, right? عليك السكينة. So this is how Sayyidina Rasulullah used to be. Yeah. The description of him, you're not describing king. Of course, you're describing someone who he won't care for kingdoms because he got everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The king, if you someone who said, wrote a book about Rasulullah, he said, the king of akhlaq, the king of moral character. And not, a king can be king with power, with palace, with ruling certain big countries. But the one who's good in his akhlaq, we have to call him king. And if he's not good in akhlaq, what do we call? Poor in his akhlaq. Poor in his moral character. So Sayyidina Rasulullah is our source. Look to him, read about him, and you will understand how humble is he, alayhi salatu wasalam. Another hadith عن عبد الله بن زيد رضي الله عنه أنه رأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مستلقيا في المسجد واضعا إحدى رجليه على الأخرى. نعم فضل السؤال.
Abdullah bin Zayd relates that he saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم lying down in a mosque with one leg over the other.
Okay. He saw him at the mosque. He was alone at the mosque. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not with a group of people. Because in other narration, he didn't allow, he said, you shouldn't sit or lie down with the people in gathering, and you are lying down on your leg crossing other one. You see how, you know, someone sitting on his leg like that, and why? Because this is takabbur when you sit like that in the people presence. Number two, maybe the aura will appear or something is not nice, right? So, but if you are alone, yes, it's okay. So al-muhaddithin, they say, okay, this is if he was alone, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when Zayd entered, he saw him, he woke up. He seated normally, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But I saw him, yani as anyone can sit or lie down. Like us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And at the masjid, what mattress he used? Hasir, like this. This one, what you use now, this is what you call hasir. This made of nylon, what you call? But Sayyidina Rasulullah, the hasir he used, made of leaves. It's a wood, like, you know, it's nothing. I mean, it's very, yani, when you sleep, you sit sleeping on the ground. So a bit, very, yeah. So when one day, Sayyidina Umar came, and he saw Rasulullah was lying down and hasir using, and looks like he has a pain in his right side. So he was doing like that. He was massaging his يعني painful. So سيدنا عمر when saw رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he started crying. Then سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم look عمر, why are you crying? Say يا رسول الله, كسرى and Heraclius, they sleep in best beds and you are the best of Allah's creation. You sleep like that. He said, يا عمر, for them dunya and for us akhira. I am not a searcher of these type of things. So صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, because if you sleep on something better, Sahaba, maybe they want to do that. If he want someone to give him a good quality of, then the same day, many will bring. Sayyidina Uthman, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Ali, all Sahaba though, Sayyidina Abdul Rahman bin Auf, traders, they will come. They will just want one signal from him. But he is not like that. Very simple life. You see, the more simple, or the murder, the more the dunya out of your heart to be in your hand, fine. But he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he's an example. He wants to example for all, the poor before the rich. So that, you say the poor, this is a, yani for, if the, looking to the rich, when you see someone who's very rich, you say, I wish that I have his car. But if you someone poor, you say, if you have a car, you say, oh, I don't want to walk like him. I have a car, I don't want. But al-fuqara, whenever they, or al-aytam, the orphans, they're proud, you say, Rasulullah was like one of us, al-masakeen. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, Allahumma hini miskinan. Ya Allah, make me live as a miskin. Wa amitni miskinan. I want to die as a miskin. And ihshurni yawm al-qiyamah. Let me gather with al-masakin. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Jannah, though, after that, no need to be humble there. Tawadu. Because it's Allah's generosity here. Allah is the host and He will offer. We described before Ahlul Dunya. And how Allah deal with Ahlul Akhirah. The description in Quran about Ahlul Jannah is a description of kings. How Allah described the kings and queens, like how what they wear, the crown, the silk, the bangles, the silk they sleep on, how the beds, how perfect Ahlul Jannah. So Ahlul Jannah, all of them kings there, because the king of the kings wants them to be like that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever he offer you, take it. And he offered the best, subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us this barakah في الدنيا والآخرة. نعم. Okay. Next narration. عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا جلس في المسجد احتبى بيديه.
أبو سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه said, when a messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would sit in a mosque, he would do so by tucking his legs up tightly to his stomach, ihtiba, with his hands.
Ihtiba. This is what he means. When he used to sit in a masjid, that's how he used to sit, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like that. This you call ihtiba. The first one, qurfusa. This ihtiba. Right? But it's not that mean you have to sit like that. That when you sit, when you feel tired, the best as brother, the normal sitting, like Abdul Qadir, see? But if you feel tired, sit like that. Bit, you know, tired, I mean, bit. Why? Because this way, if you sit like that, it will make you feel lazy, sleepy, this way. Of course, the way we normally we sit is the normal way, like how we sit like that. But he saw him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, once sitting like that. You know, one of the narration, he was putting his head down also, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Tani, he didn't want to, no one bring for him something, or he sit like that. We will know how he used to lie down later, inshallah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, next hadith. This is very important hadith, in fact. It's a big hadith. It has so much of information. But part of it is related to our class here. عن أبي بكرة رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أحدثكم بأكبر الكبائر؟ قالوا بلى يا رسول الله. قال الإشراك بالله وعقوق الوالدين. وجلس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وكان متكئا فقال وشهادة الزور أو قول الزور. فما زال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقولها حتى قلنا يا ليته سكت. نعم.
أبو بكر رضي الله عنه said, the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, shall I not inform you about the greatest enormities? They replied, certainly, O messenger of Allah. He replied, associating partners with Allah and insolence to one's parents. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat up as he had been reclining and said, and false testimony or false statement. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept saying it so much so that we said to ourselves, if only he would be quiet.
When Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam once was sitting with the Sahaba, and he said, what is related to us, in fact, he said in the hadith here, and he was reclining sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yani a pillow. There is a pillow, and when he sits, he put his arm on that pillow. All right, a bit. Then he was saying to them, shall I tell you the greatest sins, al-kaba'ir? This greatest sins is very dangerous. Very, very, very dangerous. In narrations, once he said three types of sins, like this hadith, other narration 7, other narration 10. But in this hadith, they say he minimized that the top of the sins, the biggest sins, which bring Allah's anger in dunya and akhirah. May Allah protect us. And this need a very special tawbah nasuh. Very special what? Tawbah nasuh, that you won't do the same again. May Allah protect us. Number one, shirk. Association with Allah other than Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Against the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator. Second, insolence the one's parents, yani disrespect parents. Subhanallah, in Quran, whenever Allah mentions, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ, the best of the good deeds, worship other than Him. You shouldn't worship other than Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Huh? La ilaha illallah. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Number two, be good to parents. In Quran, many number of times. Together, it's come after Tawheed. After Tawheed. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Here, about the sins. That one, the best of good deeds. Here, the sins. The biggest sins. Shirk and disrespect parents. How the disrespect start? All types of, no one can say, okay, if you shout, no. If you say, uff, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا uff, يعني أه, what you call it? This consider عقوق. Big sin. What the big sin going to happen to the person who continue like that? He will die in su'ul khatima, in a bad end. Na'udhu billah, may Allah protect us. Bad end. So here he said, this is the biggest sins. Number one, shirk. Two, aquq al-walidain. And he was sitting like that. Then he stood, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sat like that. And he said, and false testimony, shahadat al-zur. You witness, you say something about something which is not false. You are saying false. He said, this is the biggest sin. Yeah, and you say, I have seen and you have not seen. Or I have not seen and you have seen, in fact. Many people lost their rights, they lost maybe their life, they lost everything because of testimony from one. Especially we depend on shahada, shahada testimony, you know. Shahada al-zur, may Allah protect us. It's easy to say. You see, when he says shahada al-zur, false testimony is big sin. That means if you say right, is a great good deed. Sah? The opposite. Correct? If this is false testimony, how about if you say the truth? Huh? Sometimes people find difficult to say the truth, especially children. Why? Because the parents, maybe they somehow did not teach them how to be rightful or how to say the truth. Al-alim, ahad al-salihin, said to his son, my son, say the truth to me always, but don't lie. Because when you lie, you make me small, and it is aquq al-walidain also. Disrespect me. Please say the truth, because the one who say the truth, he's a hero. And the one who lie, he's a zero. You need to know how to say the truth. Like there is one boy, he want to say the truth. So he broke the dish, the plate, fall down, broken. So mother, who said this? Said, not me. Then who? Say, my hand. Say, I said the truth, but... Okay, so we need to teach them from beginning, and for that we have to be truthful first. Sai, Amman call, say my father not at home, he forgot the phone in the uncle, my father said he is not in the Allah. Islam is focusing on all these things. And this is very dangerous. May Allah protect us. Al Muhaddithin said he was. He said the hadith first time, once, then he sat and repeat the whole thing again. That's one of the narrations. Second narration, he said he was sitting putting his hand like that. This is muttaka, we call muttaka. Mm-hmm. But when he reached to falls, this one, he stood. Why? Al-ulama said, false testimony. The biggest and the greatest testimony in our life is what? Ashhadu an la ilaha wa ashhadu anna. How about someone say that, but he falls on that? Fa'alam, Allah said, fa'alam annahu la ilaha illallah. Ilm, you have to know what that means. I am your, ya Allah, iyyaka na'bud, I am your servant, and you are my Lord. I will follow whatever you say for the goodness of my life and my akhirah. I will do good to my parents. I will be good to my family. I will be a humble person. I will be generous. I will be forgiving. I will pardon. I will talk nice. I will say good. This is all our teaching in the Quran. If someone says, that's all, we became Muslim, yani khalas. Yeah, and if it's Sayyidina Rasulullah, he wants from them only say La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. That's all, khalas. So say, you go, do whatever you want. This is deen. Yeah, and you sign contract with a company, for example, to work, and they're giving you, offer you a good salary, everything. Okay, I signed the contract, that means I work for you, give me a salary. But you didn't know anything. Yeah, okay. Is that acceptable? La hawla wa la quwwata. So shahadat Allah is you have granted something and show us now how you're going to go to Jannah through this thing. Through ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa Muhammad Rasulullah. Through the testimony of la ilaha illallah. How are we going to do that? So when he reached to shahadat al-zur, because he's compiled everything. False testimony. May Allah protect us. There is a saying that there is a court. A joke, I'm not sure it's real or not, but I have one alim mentioned about it. Next, nearby the court, there is a cafe. All false witnesses there, sitting, ready to hire them. You have any case, bring them, pay them. They will say, wallahi, whatever. So one day, someone who has a case and he needs a witness. So he brought one of these rubbish, false witnesses. So the judge said to him, swear. Well, by what? He said, I swear by my salat, my prayer. Say, okay. Fajr, how many rak'ah? He said, four. He said, four. He said, three. Three? So the one who brought me said, two. He said, ya akhi, he never accept four and three. You think he accept two? What are you talking about? It's become in their blood, na'udhu billah. The one who lies, the one who say, I have seen and he have not seen. Many people, houses being broken because of one saying, I saw your husband, you know, that day. Khalas, the house gone. Oh, I saw your wife. House gone. Become fire, Jahannam. Many issues like that in our life. It's happened. And it's happening. That is the result. Biggest sin. I don't know how someone pray five times and fast Ramadan and he go to Hajj and he pray Tahajjud and he do like that. Na'udhu billah. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, signs of belief. Signs of what? Iman. Ya akhisan. To say the right thing or to keep quiet. Not to keep quiet by hiding the truth, but to keep quiet if you don't have nothing to say. Huh? Better. When there is something, say, no, I don't want to involve in this. Astaghfirullah, no. I don't want to, but this is not my job. Be away from it. It's signs of iman. Just be away from what. You see, this is not, put the iman aside now. Signs of humanity. The best human should be like that, correct? That's how the humanity. But Allah said, this is a humanity, and the belief is, if more you work for humanity, it shows your belief also. May Allah protect us. And a Sahaba said, and he continued to repeat it until we said, if only he will be quiet. Not that mean, we hope that he will quiet, just stop talking. No. Because he keep repeating it, the way he was repeating, Allah, false testimony, false testimony. So he was, we were a bit worried about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this situation. We feel miserable about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Huh? In this situation, he keep repeating it. Yeah. Allah, if you see, Allah, I mean, he saw, of course, because he mentioned, you know, I notice, and with the blessing of our phones nowadays, that another issue of testimony also. False. Allah, yani someone send you a message. We receive lots of messages every day. Someone, oh, they have captured like that. They have done this. They have done that. This one. All false. I don't know from where they bring this news. Huh? And what they do? They forward it. Ya akhi, have you checked? Have you made... This is also what? You have not seen it. By forwarding to others, you have mean here, you have approved it. You agree. If not, if someone, for example, someone send message, there are people walking and an incident happened. Someone fall down in a funny way. So someone record that. Huh? So it's a funny. What he do? He refer to his friend. That person doesn't know, miskin. And became a story. This is one of these, na'udhu billah, sins, which nowadays many people falling on that. When you receive that message, what you should do, if you want Allah to reward you, send back reply, say, brother, that's wrong. Do you wish to be in this same situation? And people send a message like that, or video about you? Huh? Or jokes about so-and-so, jokes, there are jokes about country, jokes about races. Huh? Joke about many things. Funny, wallahi, ajeeb. This is not deen, not humanity, nothing to do with akhlaq. We don't want to be part of this zebra, but it's, subhanAllah, it's like fire. Because if there's a fire somewhere, if you not got na'udhu billah, the fire, you will get the smoke, the smell of the smoke. May Allah protect us. So brothers and sisters, please be very careful about these things. It's sins, especially if someone who used to do that. There's a news about someone like that, someone like this, someone, you know, people start sending, I don't know, I'm not sure from where they got this thing. But there are some brothers I saw, alhamdulillah, they made in Facebook special page to say the truth about certain false news. Okay, what that mean? What has happened? And people fabricate. I don't know why fabricate that. And they create a type of division in the societies. And the whole, whoever work in the news, also in the press, that's another big issue. He's not an angel always. Most of the time, shaitan, na'udhu billah. Because if you want to say the truth, say the truth. If you want to know the truth, search of the truth. Sahih wa la, you have to search. Okay, 1, 2, 3. And you have to be neutral. In deen, in Islam, we have to be neutral. If someone did something wrong, you have to, even if you know matter who is he, you have to say the truth. You cannot say, no, he's my, you know, Muslim, so I have to support him. No, you have to say the truth. Al-Haq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-Haq. Sayyidina Ali, when Sayyidina Umar was the Amir al-Mu'mineen, Khalifa, he bought a shield from someone, Yahudi. And he said, he claimed that he didn't pay me. So what they do in the court? Sayyidina Umar said, I paid. Sayyidina Ali said, give me a proof. Proof that you have paid him. You have a bill or something, receipt? He said, no, I don't have. He said, then it's not yours. So say, khalas, you go from here. He went, Sayyidina Umar went. Person say, hey, what's happening here? Said, that's all. So that means that's my judgment. No, please. He have paid me. I forgot, or I, you know, he kept quiet or something. So that's akhlaq here. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. This is a moral character, how we should deal. Nowadays, mashallah, our people, Allah, there is a group, Muslims, all of them, they go to Hajj, Umrah, they do Milad, they do. Between them, big enmity. They just want to find a fault on one of them, and they see what they're going to do. All the group, they will talk about that person. Both of them. Is this Islam? Is this make Sayyidina Rasulullah happy? Is this make Allah happy, subhanahu wa ta'ala? No, we don't want to involve in these matters. We want to be اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Follow the straight path. Nothing to do. This life very dangerous, brothers and sisters. Don't involve yourself in something unwanted. If you want, you know about it, yes, brother. If don't want, keep quiet. No, I don't know anything. I don't want to hear anything also. That's not my job. May Allah protect us. Okay. Next hadith. عن أبي جحيفة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما أنا فلا آكل متكئا.
Abu Juhayfa رضي الله عنه said, the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, as for me, I do not eat reclining.
نعم. صلى الله عليه وسلم said, because they mention about someone who was sitting like that, متكئ, you know, reclining and eating. See, this is a jalsa of takabbur, like that, to eat like that. If you see in the movies, the kings, how they sit for this, you know, they put their like bed and he was sitting like that, his leg, and people standing and he eat the fruits or the food. Sayyidina Rasulullah says, I won't do that. I won't eat in this way. Then how he used to eat, you sit and eat, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know how he used to sit, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he eat? Brother Ghazan, show us now. That's the two positions. This is one. The other one, like tashahud, first tashahud, like that, when he eat. Not tashahud, I mean, like looks like you are eating. Or the other one is one leg up, and that's how we used to sit, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Sayyidina Rasulullah's. Sisters, you have seen that? Okay. That's the sitting of the base of Allah's creation, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that makes sahaba in. They really show him very amazing. With what? With humbleness. Is not your takabbur make people image of you, is your humbleness. how humble you are, how great in the eyes of your people. Plus, he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wants to teach people, be, try to be, lower your, you know, yourself, be humble. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, akhlaq, moral character is a platinum mold, not golden, platinum, the highest, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the highest. So we have to be, we don't, we shouldn't be silver or no, we have to be platinum also like him. Because Allah said, وَلَقَدْ كَالَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. He didn't say, look to him, he said, be like him. صلى الله عليه وسلم. InshaAllah Allah grant us this barakah. Alhamdulillah. Next hadith, عن جابر بن سمرة قال رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم متكئا على وسادة.
جابر بن سمرة رضي الله عنه said, I saw the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم reclining on a cushion.
Okay. A cushion, what we call it, pillow. Pillow. This is one of the pillow. So he used to sit like that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once, sometime on his left or his right. He is like us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he wants us to, because he's, we're looking to him, the sunnah of Sayyidina Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sahaba looking to him, I want to be like him. So he wants to say, okay, you can sit like this way, in this way, or in this way to get, but where is the beautiful part here? Okay. In Sahih al-Bukhari, in Sahih al-Bukhari, there is a in the, what you call it, the book of humility in dress, chapter of humility in dress, that Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha said that the pillow in which Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reclined was of leather, in this hadith, stuffed with palm leaves. Palm leaves. Adam, al-adam is what? Is not the leather like the leather you have, you know? No, is it just the raw leather? Another narration is a cloth. There is another stuffed with leaves, not feather or cotton, leaves. But the goodness of the ulama say about leaves, if you spray it with water, the smell of leaves is nice, and the fragrance of leaves. Plus, it gives you a bit of coolness in that weather there. So that the air con of him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like. But leaves, just something very simple. Bring that, put stuff it and sleep on it. That's all. And he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in other narrations, there are three things which you shouldn't, if someone offer you, accept from him. Don't say, say no. One, perfume, some atar, unless you have allergy or something, that's a different story, of course. Second, al-muttaka, the pillow someone for put under your back or to sit, take it also. Muttaka, you call it takia, you know? But in Arabic, muttaka, yani. And laban, milk. Milk. Because the drink of fitra, the purity. So, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Isra al-Mi'raj, they offer him water, liquor, and the liquor, what? Al-khamru al-jannah, not the. And what? The laban. So he chose the milk, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Sayyidina Jibreel say, you have chosen al-fitra, the purity. So in all, subhanAllah, in all religions, milk is something great. Ajib. And Allah mentioned about it. And he mentioned about the what full surah in Quran, al-Baqarah, where we get the milk from. And how he bring the milk, subhanAllah, that milk, there is no factory in the world can give you pure liquid like that, this milk. And it's come from where? From all the blood and the flesh and of the cow. Pure. The best to drink it, boil it, or you drink fresh immediately. The purest, the best. I myself don't like this skim milk or low cream, I don't know. Because they took everything away. What's remaining? Wallahi, I want to be like, you know, يا أخي بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كلوا من طيبات ما رزقناكم But ولا تسرفوا, of course. Don't you like, you know, be too much and through it or, no, of course, you know. But بسم الله. We say بسم الله, you'll eat and you eat. And سيدنا المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم, we say we eat. And the best thing, the food, when you eat and you leave it and you still you find you want to eat more. See, don't feel full. Three quarter. Water, air, and what? Food. Now we have what? Food and food and food. So anyway, this, so this takia, the milk, and the perfume, صلى الله عليه وسلم. He never used to say no. Okay. Last hadith, يعني, عن الفضل بن عباس رضي الله عنه قال دخلت على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في مرضه الذي توفي فيه وعلى رأسه عصابة صفراء فسلمت عليه فقال يا فضل قلت لبيك يا رسول الله قال اجدد بهذه العصابة رأسي ففعلت ثم قعد فوضع كفه على منكبي ثم قام فدخل في المسجد.
الفضل ابن عباس رضي الله عنه said, I visited the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم during his illness in which he passed away.
فضل بن عباس فضل بن عباس يعني الفضل بن عباس بن عبد المطلب, his cousin. His فضل, his رسول الله's cousin رضي الله عنه. نعم.
And he had on his head a yellow bandage or a turban. I greeted him and he replied, O Fadl, I said, at your service, O Messenger of Allah. He replied, tie this bandage on my head. So I did. He then sat up and placed his arm on my shoulder. Then he got up and entered the mosque.
Beautiful hadith, subhanAllah. Al-Fadl bin Abbas came to visit Sayyidina Rasulullah on the sickness where he passed away. He was ill, very ill, very tired. So he was sitting, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I said, and I said, salam alayhi. So salam to alayhi, salam. Say, ya Fadl. Said, yes, adir, labbaik ya Rasulullah, under your service. He said, come, help me untie this piece of cloth. Not big imama. Al-asaba is something simple. We just tie it like that. Normally when people have headache, if you know, they tie it, you know. We have seen this. And it was yellow color. Yellow in color. So I did. He said, please tie it. It was there, but he said, tie it. I wanted it very, because he was having headache, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he tied. Then he was sitting. So I was sitting next to him. And he, what he did, he put his hand on my shoulder for him to stand, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, المحدثين, they said that Sayyidina Fadl was very lucky, tabarrukan, that Sayyidina Rasulullah put that, you know, on his and stand, and then I help him, and he entered to al-masjid. That's the last, maybe last one or two last prayers before he passed away, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Naam. And this is also al-muttaka. Takya, he used something to, when he, not that mean when you sit, you have to, no, but is okay. Can put your hand and, you know. May Allah grant us the barakah of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the month of the barakah, the month of Mawlid al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah protect us and bless us all fi al-dunya al-akhirah. Ameen. Rabbana taqabbal du'ana, aghfir lana warhamna wa samihna. وارضَ عنا يا الله بما رضيت به عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين والى حضرة الحبيب العظم سيدنا المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واله وصحبه الفاتحة. الحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين. قبل الله منا ومنكم. This month, Rabi'ul Awwal, inshallah, we will every Monday and Wednesday will be Shama'il Muhammadiyya. So Wednesday, also Shama'il Muhammadiyya. Rabi'ul Awwal, inshallah. Okay? So we want to do our best to finish the book, inshallah. Hopefully we can do that. And that will be, I think, one of the greatest things you will do in your life, to read the book of Shama'il, because there is special barakah on it. Then have you received, inshallah, after the, we almost one third of the book finish, Almost. Later, inshallah, we will try our best, and hopefully, inshallah, we'll do them. Allah will help us to do that. Jazakum Allah khair. So now we read part of the Mawlid. Still have time before Azan and Salat Isha, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khair. Okay, Haji. تعالوا يا أستاذ. تعالوا. I don't have takia here. Where is my pillow here now? إلى حضرة الحبيب العظيم سيدنا المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وأصحابه وأمته الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي صل عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي صل عليه
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي بلغه الوسيلة. يا ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي
صل عليه وسلم. يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي خصه بالفضيلة. يا
ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي صل عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي وارض عن الصحابة. يا
ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي صل
عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي وارض عن السلالة. يا
ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي صل عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي وارض عن المشايخ. يا
ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي صل
عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي فارحم والدينا. يا
ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي صل
عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي وارحمنا جميعا.
يا ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي صل عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي وارحم كل مسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي
صل عليه وسلم. يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي واغفر لكل مذنب.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي صل عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي يا سامع دعانا.
يا ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي صل عليه
وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي لا تقطع رجانا.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي صل عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي بلغنا نزوره.
يا ربي صل على محمد.
يا ربي صل
عليه وسلم.
يا ربي صل على محمد. يا ربي تغشانا بنوره.
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي حفظانك وأمانك يا ربي
صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واسكننا جنانك
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي وارزقنا الشهادة يا ربي
صل على
محمد يا ربي صل
عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي حطنا بالسعادة يا ربي
صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واصلح كل مصلح
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي واكفي كل مؤذي يا ربي
صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي نختم بالمشفع يا ربي
صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
يا ربي صل على محمد يا ربي صل عليه وسلم
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر ويتم عليك نعمته عليك ويهديك صراطا مستقيما وينصرك الله نصرا عزيزا لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى
آله محمود خلقه هو محمد يعني. I always confuse anyway محمود سامي
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أول ما نستفتح به راد حديثين ورد في نبي كان قدره عظيما ونسبه كريما وصراطه مستقيما قال في حقه من لم يزل سميعا عليما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي
يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه
الحديث الأول عن بحر العلم الدافق ولسان القرآن الناطق أوحد علماء الناس سيدنا عبد الله ابن سيدنا العباس
رضي الله عنه
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال إن قريشا كانت نورا بين يدي الله عز وجل قبل أن يخلق آدم
عليه السلام
بألفي عام. يسبح الله ذلك النور وتسبح الملائكة بتسبيحه. فلما خلق الله آدم
عليه السلام
أودع ذلك النور في طينته قال صلى الله عليه وسلم فهبطني الله عز وجل إلى الأرض في ظهر آدم
عليه السلام
وحملني في السفينة في صلب نوح
عليه السلام
وجعلني في صلب الخليل إبراهيم
عليه السلام
حين قذف به في النار. ولم يزل الله عز وجل ينقلني من الأسراب الطاهرة إلى الأرحام الزكية الفاخرة حتى أخرجني الله من بين أبوي وهما لم يلتقيا
على سفاح قط. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه.
الحديث الثاني عن عطاء بن يسار عن كهب الأحبار قال علمني أبي التوراة إلا سفرا واحدا كان يختمه ويدخله الصندوق، فلما مات أبي فتحته فإذا فيه نبي آخر الزمان مولده بمكة وهجرته بالمدينة وسلطانه بالشام يقص شعره ويتزر على وسطه يكون خير الأنبياء وأمته خير الأمم يكبرون الله تعالى على كل شرف يصفون في الصلاة كصفوفهم في القتال قلوبهم مصاحفهم يحمدون الله تعالى على كل شدة ورخاء ثلث يدخلون الجنة بغير حساب.
اللهم اجعلنا منهم
اللهم اجعلنا منهم وثلث يأتون بذنوبهم وخطاياهم فيغفر لهم وثلثون يأتون بذنوب وخطايا عظام فيقول الله تعالى للملائكة اذهبوا فزنوهم فيقولون ربنا وجدناهم أصرفوا على أنفسهم ووجدنا أعمالهم من الذنوب كأمثال الجبال غير أنهم يشهدون أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. فيقول الحق وعزتي وجلالي لا جعلت من أخلص لي بالشهادة منك كمن كذب بي أرغلهم الجنة برحمتي يا أعز راجه يا أعز جواهر العقود وخلاصة إكسير سر الوجود مادهك قاسر ولو جاء ببذل مجهود وواسفك عاجز عن خسر ما حويت من خصال الكرام والجود الكون إشارة وأنت المقصود يا أشرف من نال المقام المحمود وجاءت رسل من قبلك لكنهم بالرفعة
والعلا لك شهود. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. أحضروا قلوبكم يا معشر ذوي الألباب حتى أجلو لكم عرائس معاني أجل الأحباب المخصوص بأشرف الألقاب الراقي إلى حضرة الملك الوهاب حتى نظر إلى جماله بلا ستر ولا حجاب. فلما آنى ونظهر الشمس الرسالة في السماء الجلالة خرج مرسوم الجليل النقيب المملكة جبريل يا جبريل النادي في سائر المخلوقات من أحل الأرض والسماوات بالتهاني والبشارات فإن النور المسون والسر المكنون الذي أوجدته قبل وجود الأشياء وإبداع الأرض والسماء أنقله في هذه الليلة إلى بطن أمه مسرورة أملأ به الكون نورا وأكفله يتيما وأطهر أهل بيته
تطهيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
صلى الله
عليه. فاهتز الأرش طربا واستبشارا، وازداد الكرسي الهيبة ووقارا، وامتلأت السماوات أنوارا، ودجت الملائكة تحليلا وتمجيدا واستغفارا.
سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله لا ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر.
ولم تزل أمه ترعى وأم من فخره وفضله إلى نهاية تمام أمله، فلما اشتد بها الطلق بإذن رب الخلق ودعت الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم ساجدا شاكرا حامدا
كأنه البدر في تمام. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك. يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك. أشرق الكون ابتهاجا بوجود المصطفى أحمد، ولأهل الكون أنس وسرور قد تجدد. يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك. فاقربوا يعلى المثاني، فازاروا اليمن الغرد، واستضيئوا بجمال ففي الحسن تفرد. يا سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك. ولنا البشرى بسعد مستمر ليس ينفد، حيث أوتينا عطاء جمع الفقر المؤبد. يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله
لبيك فلربي كل حمد جل أن يحسره العبد إذ حبانا بوجود المصطفى الهادي محمد. سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك مرحبا مرحبا يا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا يا رسول الله أهلا مرحبا بك إن بك نسعد مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا وبجاهه يا إلهي مرحبا جود وبلغ كل مقصد مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا واهدنا نهج سبيلي مرحبا كي به نسعد ونرشد مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي يا الله ببركة الهادي محمد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي يا الله ببركة الهادي محمد الله ربي بلغنا بجاهه الله في جوار خير مقعد يا الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي الله ببركة الهادي محمد الله وصلاة الله تغشى الله أشرف الرسل محمد يا الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي الله ببركة الهادي محمد الله وسلام مستمر الله كل حين يتجدد يا الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي يا الله ببركة الهادي محمد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي الله ببركة الهادي محمد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي الله ببركة الهادي محمد اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جعلنا الله وإياكم ممن يستوجب شفاعته ويرجو من الله رحمته ورأفته. اللهم بحرمة هذا النبي الكريم وآله وأصحابه السالكين على منهجه القويم اجعلنا من خيار أمته واسترنا بذيل حرمته واحشنا غدا في زمرته واستعمل ألسنتنا في مدحه ونصرته وحينا متمسكين بسنته وطاعته ومتنا اللهم على حبه وجماعته. اللهم أدخلنا معه الجنة فإنه أول من يدخلها وأنزلنا معه في قصورها فإنه أول من ينزلها وارحمنا يوم يشفع للخلائق فترحمها.
اللهم ارزقنا زيارته في كل سنة، اللهم ارزقنا زيارته في المدينة المنورة في كل سنة، ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين عنك ولا عنه قد رسنا. اللهم لا تجعل في مجلسنا هذا أحدا من الجماعة الحاضرين والحاضرات إلا غسلت بماء التوبة ذنوبه وسترت برداء المغفرة عيوبه. اللهم إنه كان معنا في السنة الماضية إخوة وأخوات رحمهم الله منعهم القضاء عن الوصول إلى مثلها، فلا تحرمهم ثواب هذه الساعة وفضلها. اللهم ارحمنا إذا صرنا من أصحاب القبور، وفقنا لعمل صالح يبقى سناه على ممر الدهور. اللهم اجعلنا لآلائك ذاكرين ولنعمائك شاكرين واليوم لقاك من الذاكرين، وحنا بطاعتك مشغولين، وإذا توفيتنا فتوفنا غير مفتونين ولا مخذولين، واختم لنا منك بخير أجمعين. اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين، اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين، اللهم اكفنا شر الظلم والظالمين، واجعلنا من فتنة هذه الدنيا سالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا الرسول الكريم الحبيب لنا شفيعا، وارزقنا به وبجاهه يوم القيامة مقاما رفيعا. اللهم اسقنا من حوض الكوثر حوض نبيك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا، واحشرنا تحت لوائه غدا. اللهم اغفر لنا به ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولمشايخنا ولمعلمينا وذوي الحقوق علينا ولمن أجرى هذا الخير في هذه الساعة والجماعة الحاضرين والحاضرات، ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك قريب مجيب الدعوات وغاضي الحاجات وغافر الذنوب والخطيئات، يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين. You may pray for your own dua inshallah now privately. ربنا تقبل دعانا منا واجعل طافك الخفية في كل أمورنا، واجعلنا من الذين سبقت لهم منك الحسنى. وإلى حضرة الحبيب العظم سيدنا المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى صحبته الفاتحة. الحمد لله رب العالمين. فاتحة إن شاء الله بنية الشفاء، الله سبحانه وتعالى بنية الشفاء برسالة الفاتحة. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all barakah fi dunya al-akhirah. Special dua for those whom they are need for Allah's help always. And special dua also for our brother Shafiq bin Ghazan. So Ghazan's brother, he's not well. Ask Allah to bless him speedily and fully recovery. Special dua also for our brother Jali. For Allah, sahha wal afiyah. Alhamdulillah, Allah bless him. Barakah fi dunya wal-akhirah. Inshallah, long life, good health, son. And all our brothers who are not here, we pray for them, inshallah. That Allah grant them all, their families, the best for dunya wal akhirah. For our beloved man, ya Allah, taqabbal du'ani ya kareem, bi rahmatika bi karamika ya kareem, hurmati al-Nabi wa sirri al-Fatiha. Also al-Fatiha, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah grant us all unity and protection, our family especially, tranquility within our houses, between husband and wife, parents and children. May Allah protect us from all bala and musibah, all types of sicknesses, physically and spiritually, the evil of seen and unseen. May Allah open the doors of barakah and rahmah for all of us, inshaAllah. Ameen, ya Allah, wa ala hadhihi niyya bi sirri al-Fatiha. اللهم بسر الفاتحة وبجاه من أنزلت عليه فاتحة، تقبل دعانا يا كريم ارحمنا يا رحيم، صلي وسلم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلم وسلم الحمد لله رب العالمين. تقبل الله منا ومنكم. الله خير.